guys, welcome back to Life in Brisbane channel. Today, me and Manin, we are here for telling about student life in Australia, how's it going, and...
Yeah, so telling you about student life in Australia, Brisbane.
What's the advantage and disadvantage of studying in Australia, what point it has, the things that I have to say was that uni life is so hard. So currently, I'm a third-year student that is studying in the Queensland University of Technology, and I'm studying Bachelor of the Software Engineering. And what are you studying, Joseph?
Bachelor's of IT.
Yeah.
And domestic student. So difference.
Yeah, I'm international and he's domestic. So he's almost 11 years that he's in the Brisbane. So he's kind of Aussie. And
go.
And what?
Okay, so first of all, what will you say the hardest part of being an international student is?
The hardest part is when I arrived here, I didn't know how to apply to the uni. So I found one Iranian friend that he was studying the high school even here, and I got some help from him. He helped me to how to apply. So I checked the QUT website and I choose my major. At first, I really search about my major, for example, how long it's gonna take, because some major like IT it just take 3 years to study, but some majors that actually most of the engineering majors takes 4 years to complete it. So another thing that I have to say to you guys, it's about the fee of the international student and domestic student is totally different. So international student, they have to pay like something around 22k each 3 months, which means each semester.
Semesters usually has, so one semester, you have 2 semesters in uni?
In the year.
First semester is you're from February to July maximum.
Yeah,
July. Second semester starts with August to November.
Yes.
And that's your 2 semesters. For international student, what is it, 3,000 something?
It's
more than, like 3,000 and above, yeah. Per unit. That's per unit. And you have four units?
After the year two, the fee is also increasing, so now each unit is almost 4.5k, 5k, yeah.
So basically each unit is 4.5k and you have 4 units in one semester, which means altogether roughly 20,000 above 20,000. For domestic students it's a lot more cheaper, like I pay what, 4-5,000 per year?
Yeah.
1,000 something per unit.
Yeah.
So basically
so
like
good.
One quarter of what he pays I pay for the whole unit instead. Something else to talk about that. Okay, so start off with how you got the admission to uni. So you said you applied through QUT website.
Yeah.
And you had to do what, IELTS bands or PTE? What you had to do?
So the things that they ask us for applying for the things that all the university in Australia ask you for applying on that, it's two things that is important. One of them, it's a certificate that you have from your country. You have to prove them you finished 12 years. So in my country, after we finishing the 12 years, we're getting something like diploma certificate. That is totally different with the diploma that you have idea about it in the other countries. So, and the second thing that we need, it's the IELTS exam or PTE. That for the PTE,
I think minimum 65 above, I think.
I don't know about the PTE honestly, but for IELTS, because I got the IELTS exam, the minimum score that you need for the diploma if you wanna apply is 5.5, and for the bachelor is above 6.
6 each?
Yeah, 6 each.
Second thing, okay, so now we talked about how to get in uni.
How you domestic students?
Domestic, it's easy.
ATAR. So tell them what's the ATAR, because I didn't know ATAR. What was it?
ATAR is basically like your 12th marks, basically what you get from school. And then from that percentile marks, you get your ATAR on how much subject you study. You need English and maths, prerequisite, and you just apply.
Second thing is
about uni is, so you first you apply to uni, you get your acceptance letter in India or wherever you study international student wise. And then you get your COE, confirmation of enrollment.
Yeah.
You also get that. And then you get your visa, you fly to here. What do you think are the 5 important things? Because you came from international, from Iran. So like I know some people told me 5 important things needed is, first of all, you come, you apply for your TFM to work and get your job thing.
Yeah. TFN so is tax file number.
He will put the link where to get the TFN. Yeah. It takes like 21 days, so that's the first important thing. Second thing is your bank account.
Yeah, you have to create a one bank account because you really need it. Australian people doesn't use a lot of cash, they're just using the, by tapping the phone or just having the card.
Apple Pay or something, yeah. And what bank do you think? Commonwealth?
My personality, my favorite personality bank is the Commonwealth. This is the first account that when I came to Australia, just opened it. And yeah, I think Commonwealth is a good bank for the students.
Mm.
Because it doesn't get you any, what's they call, rate, percentage rate each month.
So yeah.
Because for the student, it's the free.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah.
What else were you said? TFN first thing, second thing is your, what's it called?
Third thing is the accommodation.
Accommodation, that's important. So in city, what if it's like $400, $300, between $350 to $400 per week?
Yeah.
For what? Single room, is it? Single room with shared accommodation in South Bank or somewhere like that. What about like normal housing, you can get $200, $300, but away from city, that's good. And that's also shared accommodation. And what else is there?
You have a lots of different accommodation like SK or what's that? GAO?
Yeah, so like
it's
lots around.
Near the KG campus. It's exactly from
mostly
the KG
people
campus.
Enroll in universities wise, they enroll in what unis you think they enroll in? I think QUT, then Griffith, lots of people enroll in Griffith. UQ, some international
students. Yeah, some international. Because it's a little hard for getting. It needs, I think, the higher IELTS score and also the ATAR. Because
you know, your girlfriend just messaged me now. So continue.
I don't have any girlfriend. And what else?
Okay.
Cut.
So once you have applied to the uni and you get the acceptance letter, you would come here, you enroll your subjects. So you probably go to the uni for one day to just double check with all your teachers.
Yeah.
You have your first week of uni, which is orientation, which we will show, which Ali will show.
Yeah, we will record the video of that.
Yeah, which will be like, so orientation is 1 week of uni that you come in.
And they call it 4 week as well.
Orientation week, which just has you started up on uni, like what the uni offers, the programs, its clubs, everything like that, which will be in the video.
And they have some events on that day.
So yeah, so like all, and you have like, so let's say if he comes from Iran, there's like Persian or Iranian group that you can join. Just to get more friends, build up, and maybe help you with jobs. Like I, India, you have Indian club, everything like that. So
each country has a different.
Different. Yeah. What else we are talking about on here? Cut. So once you have applied to the uni, you got COE, you go to the orientation week. Now you know 20,000 fees is quite a lot.
Yeah.
You can get it reduced by going to the scholarship page. So I know QUT has like QUT scholarship page, which will be somewhere here. He will put a screenshot or like where to apply. You can write all your description, like undergraduate. From undergraduate, you will write, like you can choose what course you're studying, how many years you have.
And also, I got the scholarship last semester. Yeah, I couldn't believe that. I got almost like 14k scholarship. That really helps me for paying the fee of the uni. And this semester I got a scholarship again, but not that much like last year. I just got 6k.
Scholarship wise, so your scholarship is done through your uni's website. You just go to write your uni's name and scholarship, like QUT scholarship. You have all your options like equity. International students have much options than domestic in this case. Domestic, it's really hard to get a scholarship, but international, it's very easy to get a scholarship. Like you didn't even know you had scholarship till you got it. But so you can apply before or while studying. You can also apply.
The important thing that is needed for the scholarship is something that they call it GPA. So the GPA, it's a
grade point average.
Average of all of the unit that you pass. Each unit is graded by 1 to 7. So 4 is the pass, upper the 4 is the pass, and 3 is the fail,
So they have basically fail, low fail, credit, pass, high distinction.
Like distinction all and high distinction.
But
so last semester, because I got 2 distinction and 1 credit, so I got a scholarship because my GPA, it wasn't good before. But
what is it right now? After like 3 years done, what's your GPA?
After 3 years, it's like 4.8 now. And because I think I increased from the 4 to 4.8,
they make sure you don't fail, because if you fail, you get one or two, and then it your GPA just goes down. So you need like to make it go back up. You need like
it's really
sixes
hard to
or
try
five.
To getting to back it up. So,
food. Okay, so food is offered like in uni. You can go to like food court. I know QT Gardens Point has better food than.
We have lots of different restaurants more than the Kelvin Grove.
More than Kelvin. But Kelvin Grove, you have to walk down and you will find lots of restaurants there.
We will show you what's that, the Kelvin Grove campus very soon. And we have one video that we showed the Garden Point campus. If you didn't watch, you have to click here and watch that video. What else we can talk about? Oh.
So last topic we're going to talk about, so we've talked about how uni you need to apply, what you need for uni requirements, scholarship we've talked about, we've also talked
the
about facilities in uni,
arrive.
Basic necessities of uni when we arrive, background, ignore them like you should ignore all your haters, and Ali has lots of haters in the uni.
No one has a friend more than me in the uni. I'm not joking. Seriously, I'm
okay. Continue. Stop. Bougie. Nice
bougie.
Continue.
No, seriously.
Okay, so three things we've talked... 3, 2, 1, start from here, okay? Three things we've talked about till now is, first of all, how to apply. Second of all, your uni scholarships and everything, how to make your fees lower. Necessity, your TFN that you need. We will talk about necessity things in another video that we will record later on. But third thing, so now you're talking about you need to study, you need to do everything, how you will study, where you will study. So uni has libraries, like we know QUT has big libraries, small pods everywhere, and they're open for students 24/7. Some parts are open for 24/7.
But after the 7 o'clock, you need to have a student ID for entering.
You need to apply for your student ID.
Oh yeah, we forgot to say that. The second thing that you have to do it after applying for university, it's you're getting your student ID, because you really need it for the entrance to the each block or library after the 7, or for the exams you need that one, for what else you need it. If you want to use the go-kart for transport.
No,
if you,
that's you, another if, thing I was going to mention is for go-karts, you need to apply online. Like if you're in Queensland, it's like translink.com. Apply through there, put your, it takes 1 to 2 days for them to accept your uni tertiary requirement, and once it's accepted,
then you
do they
get
go
discount
further
for the each tab of
so you get like a cheaper price because you're on concession basically. So make sure you apply for go-kart is your second thing. You come in Brisbane, you apply for
or if you're rich, you can buy a car. But the things that it is the what's that, the fee of the parking in the Garden Point, because it's located on the city, it's too expensive. I think each hour is like $8, and after that it's increasing to like $50 just in a day.
Third
but
thing,
in the Kelvin Group 1, the parking of that is cheaper than here, because it's a little far from the city, but it's still in the city.
Okay, now we will talk about our experience currently in uni. So out 3 years you've done in uni, he started off with diploma. So what you can do is, if you don't have the requirement to get into a bachelor, or if you want to study in QUT and you don't have the requirements to study in bachelor's, you can study the diploma of that. Like QUT offers diploma of engineering, which he went through first year, and that
and
first year that diploma only goes for 1 year. So that 1 year diploma,
that 1 year is account as the first year of the bachelor, so you don't lose
so
your,
it's 100%
you don't waste your time,
100% guaranteed entry in bachelor's of engineering once you've done your diploma of engineering. So your first year is done, you start from second year,
because
and
second
you only have
bachelor.
2 years, you'd only have 2-3 years left. Once that's and that's also offered for bachelor's of engineering, diploma of engineering, so you can just do that, get to bachelor's. Diploma of IT, second year into IT, 100% guaranteed.
So you're not wasting your time.
Yeah, so it's offered in that, and you have additional. So once you want, if you've done diploma already, you at least have a diploma, and you can apply for jobs as well.
Yeah.
You have more possibility to get jobs once you have diploma and then go second year, rather than doing bachelor. So up to, and that fees is cheaper, a little bit like $100-$200 cheaper as well.
Yeah. Definitely.
And you meet lots of people there because it's a smaller block, and that's done in Kelvin Grove.
Yeah. Well, and I recommend for the international students, because they come to the another country and the main language of here is English, and if they are not much good in English,
familiar
like
with English.
Me, because I wasn't, honestly, I wasn't good that much that I am in
still
the English.
Still not, but okay.
But yeah, this is why I choose going to the diploma. It really helps me to, what's that, improving my English skills.
Second of all, it's smaller groups, so you have more people to know, more community.
Yeah, it's easier to start making new friends in the diploma until the bachelor. Because in the bachelor, everyone came from the high school and they have their own friends, so they're spending time with them more. But in the diploma, you can find more international friends and make friends.
And unfortunately, I had to study diploma because I thought I got admission in bachelor's, but I wanted to study diploma because some personal reasons. But what happened is, I unfortunately met a person and now I'm making video with him. So for domestic students, don't study diploma, otherwise you will be stuck with friends like him. International, study diploma, otherwise you will be stuck in good place with me.
Yeah.
Third of all, so diploma you can study, bachelor you can study, masters even you can study, easy. Job wise, make sure when you come here you're confident with English. And
yeah, English is, I think, main problem of the international students. But honestly, the tutoring here, it's
self-paced. Self-paced. So you need to be on top of your work before you even start studying. So like before the teachers, because they teachers don't explain much. They don't explain anything.
Yeah, and actually they don't know you at all. Even the semester finish, if you go there, say, "Hi, do you know me?" They don't know who are you. They do not much care about you in the, because it's a lot of students. But what's that?
But make sure you're on top of your study. So four things now we've gone through. First of all, scholarship. Second of all, your ways to get into uni. Third of all, diploma, whatever not. TFN we've already talked about. And lastly, what we're going to talk about just before we finish the video off.
What is it about?
It's regarding how to basically travel in uni. So traveling wise, you have your bus, which has go-kart, as I mentioned. Train, which has go-kart, train stations.
And the third one that is just for our uni, it's ferry.
Ferry, not for our uni, UQ as well.
Okay, UQ, but what about Kelvin Grove?
Kelvin Grove is, again, train is best or bus is best. Bus best.
QUT, Garden Point campus, it has their own ferry station.
Yeah, UQ as well. UQ has
I don't know about the UT.
But UQ. As well as that, last thing to finish off is orientation week. Do attend that week to know your uni more.
Yeah,
and every uni has their own sort of small space for students to study. So don't feel like you can't study in uni. It's quiet. Everything is normal. Yeah. Lots of study space, lots of new opportunities. Use it to the best. One tip we both recommend. Do not trust everyone in uni.
Yeah.
Know who you are going to trust.
You can friend with everyone, but don't try to make your best distance. Friend. You
distance.
Know?
Yeah. Yeah, have distance.
Yeah.
Don't. One lesson I've learned in uni: don't trust everyone. Like I trust few people, he trusts few people.
Yeah.
They break it at the end of the day. So.
But most of them very good.
Most of them good.
And most of them you already know: Franklin, Odo, Gursu. You know most of them.
But don't trust everyone. Yeah. Main tip. So next video we will talk about necessary things.
Show them the orientation. Orientation day.
But next thing is necessary things. In Australia as a student, so like your TFN, we will go in depth about that. So we will go about TFN and everything like that, like your jobs, how you can apply for jobs, where you can get the jobs. So next video,
and you can also comment it
if you have any questions, just comment.
For example, if you have what's that problem to how to apply on the website, because it's really
because I think
hard.
Sometimes you have lawyers who apply for you and
say that one, there is some issue.
Yes, solicitors, lawyers, and everything.
I got the help from them for applying.
So do talk to them about it.
You can comment if you have any questions from my video.
Or any videos you want to know about.
Yeah, we can make for you.
Okay. So that's it for the video.
One thing that I forgot to say. When you're watching this video now, I think we reached now 1K subscriber. It's a really big thing for us. And I really appreciate it for your support. I hope we can make a more better video for you guys and show.
If anything is bad in quality, do comment and we will improve.
What else?
That's it.
Don't forget to subscribe our channel and like.
More tips for uni is coming soon.
See you in the next video. Peace out.
Chalo, milte hain. Yo, You're okay. It's all post, man. Subscriber fans. No, see? No bullshit, but you bullshit all the time. Fans, subscribe.
Yeah, guys, you don't know how the fans coming us for taking the photo, getting the
sticker. I'm out. Okay, go continue. Okay. So, scholarship point?